Fever and pain are extremely common in pediatric age. And regarding fever, the use of paracetamol is recommended when fever is associated with other systemic symptoms that cause, for example, fatigue or other kind of problems to the child. So fever should be considered like a reaction to an infection or an inflammatory condition, and it should be treated when it is associated with these systemic symptoms, because otherwise it is a sort of reaction to the problem of the child. So regarding the treatment, usually it is recommended to administer drugs like paracetamol or ibuprofen at a dosage that should be, in the case of paracetamol, 15 mg per kilogram per dose, with a maximum of times per day of 6 times. And then regarding ibuprofen, the dosage is 10 mg per kilogram per day, with a maximum of 40 mg per kilogram per day. So this treatment is recommended in that cases. The temperature should be evaluated at the axillary level using the electronic thermometer. And regarding other kind of drugs, some of the other drugs are not recommended in the first years of life for potential complications, like, for example, drugs like cortisonic or ESA that can be associated with adverse events in the first years of life. Then the other point is that even when there is an infection, anyway, it is extremely important to treat the infection and then treat the fever as a sign of infection, but limiting the use of the drugs to that recommended according to this kind of guidance that has been published in the national and international literature. Regarding the pain, nowadays the position is totally different from the previous position. So the pain in children should be treated. It is obvious that the pain has a sort of subjective evaluation. But anyway, it is extremely important to avoid that the child has a sensation of pain because of the possibility to modify his or her pain receptors and then have the sensation to advertise pain too early in other similar conditions. In that case, again, paracetamol and ibuprofen are the two recommended drugs at a dosage that is similar to the dosage recommended for fever. If the pain is of moderate entity, it is important, it is extremely important to administer the drugs at the fixed hours in order to avoid period in which the child has the perception of pains. In other conditions, like for example actutatis media or pharyngotonsillitis, the pain should be treated in presence of symptoms. Anyway, the news regarding pain management in children is that pain should be treated and that even the neonates has a sensation of pain, something that is totally different from the previous position in which pain was treated just in the case of severe associated diseases. So I think that it is an important news that should highlight the importance of pain evaluation by healthcare workers and the importance of the knowledge of pain management by healthcare workers and also by the parents.